In this screencast, we're going to look at the arrangement of two isothermal reactors in series, a plug flow reactor and a continuous stirred tank reactor. And the question we want to answer is, does the order that we arrange them, whether it's the plug flow reactor or the CSTR that's first, affect the final conversion? And the short answer is, yes, it does. For example, in a second order reaction, we're going to get a higher conversion if the plug flow reactor is first, so we can carry out reaction at the high concentration of reactant where we get a high rate of reaction. However, for a first order reaction, it does not matter. This is a result of the equations being linear for the mass balances, and what we want to do in the screencast is work through and look at those equations. So here's the two situations that we want to analyze, a CSTR followed by a plug flow reactor, plug flow reactor followed by a CSTR. The volumes of the plug flow reactor and the CSTR are not the same, and the reaction first order. And so what we're going to do is write down the mass balances. First, we're going to write the mass balance for the CSTR. So it's steady states, there's no accumulation, there's flow of A into the system. Feed concentration C is zero. Small v is the volumetric flow rate. So this is the molar flow rate in, the molar flow rate out. Look at a liquid phase system, so the volumetric flow rate is the same. CA1, and the difference is a result of the fact that we have reaction, which is at concentration CA1 because it's a CSTR, and then the volume of the CSTR. Now we can arrange this equation to solve for CA1. And so the concentration at the x of the CSTR is linearly proportional to the concentration entering the CSTR because it's first order. For the plug flow reactor, we have a differential equation, the volumetric flow rate, the change in the concentration as a function of cumulative volume as we move down the plug flow reactor. And again, a first order reaction. Now this we're going to rearrange and integrate. And so note that I've integrated along the cumulative volume V sub P. The inlet concentration is CA1. The outlet concentration is CA2. And so this gives me an equation relating concentration to the volume and the volumetric flow rate. So after integrating, then I rearranged. And again, you notice that CA2 is linearly related to CA1, and then CA1 we obtain from the CSTR. So we're going to write down the result for CA1, and now we have an equation that relates the exit concentration from the two reactors in terms of volumetric flow rates, the volumes of two reactors, and the rate constant. But the important thing to note is this linear relationship. We're going to do the same calculations for the reverse order and observe similar behavior. So I've written down the equation now for the system here, the plug flow reactor. So the inlet concentration CA0 and the outlet CA1. So I get a similar relation to what I've derived before. And then similarly, CA2 is going to be related to CA1 by the same equation as here. But now the inlet to the CSTR is CA1, the outlet is CA2, and then I can substitute for CA1 into this equation, and you can see that we get the exact same equation for the outlet concentration, the reactant, when we have the plug flow reactor first as when we have the CSTR first. And you can also observe from looking at the equation the linear relationships we have here, that CA1 is linearly proportional to CA0, and then we have here that CA2 is linearly proportional to CA1. Thus, switching the order does not make a difference, and we're going to get the same conversion for these two systems. For a first order reaction, only for a first order reaction, the only other type reaction where we get the same conversion would be a zero order reaction, because that doesn't depend on concentrations at all.